Genius Academy, Crypto Basics Series, Part 2, DeFi. The term DeFi is a shortened version of decentralized finance. It is decentralized, meaning it uses the same open, accessible technologies as cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Cardano, and finance as in any financial service. But common services include exchanging different currencies, lending and borrowing, and earning interest. DeFi is a modern blockchain-based approach to centralized finance, which refers to more traditional and custodial financial services like banks, afterpay or payday loan services, stock trading, and more recently, even cryptocurrency exchanges like Coinbase and Binance. Typically, these services will require you to prove your identity, make an account, and send your funds to it, and will charge a fee for the services they provide. In this centralized model, you have to trust that the exchange will take care of your assets and keep them available for you to access when required. Decentralized finance services, on the other hand, do not require this level of trust and instead allow you to retain custody of your assets, do not require KYC, know your customer, or identification, and are often much cheaper to use. DeFi services run on smart contract blockchain platforms, initially the Ethereum blockchain, but are starting to become popular on other blockchains as well, such as Cardano. As such, they inherit the security and transparency of the underlying blockchain. Some key fundamental elements of DeFi are smart contracts. DeFi is only possible due to the introduction of smart contracts, which allow all the different types of finance functions, such as swapping, lending, and borrowing, to be programmed. Decentralized exchanges. These are decentralized applications that allow users to swap between different cryptocurrencies with no KYC and while letting users retain custody of their assets until a deal is executed. Stablecoins. These are tokens pegged one-to-one to fiat currencies and are seen as safe ways to keep your money in the crypto ecosystem while not being exposed to its volatility, which is particularly handy in downtrends. Low fees. As DeFi is all code running on chain, there are no middlemen or other overheads. As long as you are using blockchains with low fees, the cost of using these services is lower than traditional finance. Lending and borrowing. Since cryptocurrencies are taxed as assets in many countries, borrowing has become a popular service, as you can retain your cryptocurrency while using it as collateral for a loan in another currency, such as a stablecoin. As long as you adhere to the terms of the loan, you can eventually pay it back and regain custody of your cryptocurrency. It's important to be aware, however, that not all DeFi applications are safe. There have been numerous hacks and failures, so it is advised to do some research on both the underlying blockchain as well as the application itself, and exercise caution when using these services. Okay. This concludes our second Crypto Basics series video on the topic of decentralized finance. Make sure to subscribe to this channel if you'd like to stay informed about Genius Academy, and follow us at the different social media accounts that will be shared in the description box below. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for our next video on the topic of Cardano.